Alright, let's see piece by piece from my code what I want to show you today. Here I have three type devs. I have my type dev integer named data, and inside my struct node, this is my struct, I have one integer named number, and I have a type dev struct node pointer that points to that struct, and I have a field that's called next. Okay, this is my struct name node, this is my node, this is my pointer, this is the data of my struct. I have to use a global variable here, name list is the first pointer of the list, and when I create this linked list, I say that this pointer will be null, and when I move the pointer to the next memory address, I write this command here. Asterisk p arrow next. Now have my insert function here. If this pointer here is null, then we use the insert start function, this function here. Okay. Otherwise, if this pointer here points to a memory address, I use this function here. Okay. You can see all these functions here. With this function, I print all the nodes from the list. Okay. And the remove function, what it does, it accepts a pointer here, and to the temporary pointer stores the memory address of the next pointer of this pointer here, of the local variable. It uses a local variable and takes a parameter that is by call. We call this with the value of this memory address here, and we say that the temporary would be the value of the next pointer of this pointer, and then we call the rem function. What it does here, it simply moves this pointer to the next memory address, and after that it frees the temporary and says that the temporary will point to null, so it deletes the next pointer of this parameter here. Okay, this pointer points to memory address. The next memory address of this memory address is been deleted. Okay. Now here, how to create a list? Very easy. You have to use the to say that the list will point to null, and after that you use this pointer here, PRO, to point to the same memory address as the list pointer, and then for I equals to 1 to 10, to number 10, the I increases, variable, this local variable 10 increases, we insert the list and this pointer here and this number here, the I. Now if the I is equals to 1, that means that we have inserted the number 1 into our list with these two pointers. We have to say that this pointer here would point to the same memory address as the list, so we don't lose this pointer because we want to use it uses this variable here, this pointer, to the next insert function, okay? And if the I is greater than or equal to 2, we move ahead. We say that this pointer here will point to the next memory address. So in every loop, within every loop inside this for, we move this pointer continuously to the next memory address. Now in my main, I create the list, then I print all the nodes, and I use a pointer, temporary pointer, that points to the same memory address as the list. I initialize the random function, and then while it's not empty, the next pointer of the list remember is this pointer here, is a global variable, and the next is a pointer inside the mouse track that points to the next memory address, remember. Okay. Now, I say that I will count this number here, random, from 0 to 10, to 9, and I print all the numbers inside my list. And I move to the next memory address, my current pointer. Now be careful. What happens if the current reaches the end of the list is null and the I is not equals to j minus 1? That means that we have to count again from the beginning of our list. So that's why here I'm writing current is on list, equals to list. And what happens if I has reached the top of the counting, the end of the counting? We have to say that we have to remove or delete the first node, the node that points to the points that the list points to. That's why here my C variable first is 0 and then here becomes 1. And I say that the current will point to the list. Okay. The same here, if we have reached the end of the list, the last node of the list, the current next will be null. So that's why here I say C will be 1. So here, if C is equal to 1, I remove the node, I remove the list, else I remove the current. Okay. Okay. Let's run to C. I will count things nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And will be deleted the next node. So number 7 will be deleted. I will count 2 nodes, 6 nodes, 5 will be deleted, 7 nodes, 4 will be deleted, 9 nodes, 4 nodes, and winner is 10. Okay. Okay. Let's run it again once more. You see here the 8 has been deleted, 9 has been deleted, 10 has been deleted, 7 has been deleted, 4 has been deleted. Here 7, so it deletes 1. I have no message for this deletion. For this, so here it deletes node with number 1. Number 1 node that points to the list, at this node, at this memory address. So winner is 5 this time. Thank you very much. I hope to give you an idea. It's very interesting. The ring lists are very interesting. Gucci language. And you can see my functions here. Okay, goodbye.